AMT has reissued another very popular classic kit, the 1962 Chevy Bel Air Super Stock 409 Turbofire. It's in 1/25th scale. It is a 2-in-1 kit, which means you can build either the beautiful Dino Don Nicholson's 409 Dragster, or you can build a completely stock Bel Air 409. So let's take a look at everything that's in the box when you get yours. First up, lots of accessory parts in here, and extra parts will be left over. These are the dump pipes for the Dragster version. We've got valley covers, we've got high-rise intakes, air cleaners, we've got full headers, we've got a tow hitch for the Impala. It's even got the little tongue release there, the little tongue lock on it, that you can attach to the front of the frame to drag it around the racetrack. We've got manifolds here, front suspension, springs. These are your spindles in the front, or your wheel backs right there. We've got radiator, firewall, rear suspension with the links all built in, and the pipe right there. We've got our seat backs, drive shaft, optional hood hinges if you want to pose it with an open hood, radiator line. We've got our stock exhaust system, so you can see it's a separate exhaust system, not molded in. That'll make a lot of you happy. We got our floor pan, and as you can see, it doesn't have the rear seats in it, doesn't have any of the other seats marked in there, so you can place stuff in if you want to do the Dragster version to lighten it up. Speaking of that interior, we've got very, very detailed door panels. Excellent molding on those. Rear and front seats. Nice dashboard with detail. Got our pedals in there and our steering column and steering wheel. But yeah, those door panels, check that out. Excellent detail and risen enough off the body to actually detail your own. We got a set of nice custom wheels, unpainted, so you can do what you want. We've got a stock intake, valve covers, some more wheel backs for you. On this one here, we've got our block halve and transmission. Cylinder heads, which if you wanted to leave a valve cover off would look nice. Stock valve covers. All sorts of small parts for the engine, carburation, starter, oil filler, distributor, alternator, master cylinder, belt and pulley. Make sure we got our battery in there. There's our steering column. Transmission support. Water pump. Nice steelies on there and wheel backs. Got a stockish air cleaner. Got our nice slab hood. More springs and shocks. Nice detail under that hood. And it does have a cutout if you go with the optional high-rise. You can cut those out. On the chassis here, you can see the exhaust was not molded in as we saw earlier. Got that nice X design. Everything's molded in an off-white, not a bright white. That's why it shows up so nice on camera. And that big old 409 body. I'd love to put Beach Boys music on here, and you'll say in the comments, how come you didn't use the Beach Boys music? Well, because that costs about $50,000. So the viewer that wants to send me that in cash, so I know it's real, I'll put Beach Boy music on one video, because that's what it'll cost. So as soon as someone wants to mortgage their house and send me 50 grand, otherwise we'll just look at this awesome body, play free music during the building sessions. Sweet detail. And enjoy all the fun. Switch to the other side of the desk. We've got transparent red taillights. Nice design to them. They should push right in. We've got a single steel axle that I saw. We've got 1, 2, 4, 6 tires. Stock white walls. These are also put on the front. You can see the box art. Big white wall on the front on a chrome steely and black on the back. So you've got 4 of these. They do have the Firestone name imprinted on them. Nice bias ply tread. You'll get 4 printed nicely. And a set of their awesome blue line Goodyear slicks. Pad printed on one side. Flat on the other. Does have the nice Goodyear logos and everything on that back side. If that's the type you wanted to use. Small chrome tree. Plenty of detail. We got shifters, mirrors, bumpers. The headlights are separate. Hubcaps, so you build a stock one. We've got our hood trim there. Looks like we got some small gauges nice chrome tree. Clear parts, separate back glass, separate windshield, side windows, and our headlights. All nice and crystal clear. Finally, the decal sheet with a ton of stuff on it. These right here say US 82, just so you know what it's for. Otherwise, we got Mr. Stock Eliminator. We got decals to replicate the box art. We've got Nally and Nicholson Dino Shop. Contingency decals. Two sets of gauges. Three sets of Chevy emblems. Three Bel Air emblems. And three 409 emblems on the upper side there. So you've got all kinds of stuff to replicate. We've got two sets of license plates on there. Don Nicholson logos. Owner Don. All that awesome stuff on that beautiful decal sheet up close. That's everything that's in the box. I'm going to get to gluing mine together, and I'll be right back. Thank you. Welcome back to this easy, no-nonsense build, quite enjoyable to assemble. I like the older, simple kits a lot of the time. Slump Breakers gives you something easy to work on, but when we're done, we're going to have a pretty cool-looking model as far as I can tell. We got the interior all set. As you can see, I removed the back seat. This is a gasser. I'm not going to put the back seat in it, and that's what's nice about this interior tub is we don't need to put the back seat in it. We've got the seat back glued on. We've got our nice door panels, our dashboard. We can paint those all up together. We got our steering wheel. We can do the same with that. We got our belt, pulley, and generator, battery, and ignition box. We will spray the ignition box, then we will do some hand painting on that, hand detailing on the battery, and we'll leave the generator and fan and pulley system the black that we painted. We've got our nice high-rise intake here with the two four-barrel carburetors. Makes for a very nice unit, even has an oil filler, distributor, and coil. So we can get that painted. We'll do that up in a metallic tone. I'll do the carburetors in another minute. Whoa! Almost lost it. Guess the glue didn't hold. I should have waited a few minutes longer. But the two carburetors are there. I'll re-glue those back together properly with my model glue, and then we'll be all set. We've got our interior tub. I just leave those on there so I have something to hold on to when I paint it. We've got the hood here on its own little tree. We'll get that painted up. I've got the firewall glued in with the blower motor and the master cylinder. I can accent those later, but I like to make sure that that firewall is glued in. When you place it in, it should just be a little forward. You can see that little triangle of plastic on either side. It will snap into place behind that marker, and then you want to bring it all the way down so that it meets these little triangles here, these little supports on these little shelves on the inner fender. You'll just make sure that all fits in tightly, run your glue in, and you are set for the body, and then I remove those columns that were there so we can get paint everywhere. We got our rear wheels assembled because these tires are hollow, so they'll be very easily pushed over that. The front tires are not quite, they're a little hollow, but they're very, very stiff. So I did the wheel backs with the pins in them and glued those in tightly, since I don't want my models to roll because they'll fall off my shelf and I'll scream. We got our wheel fronts here. Those I will press and friction fit when we're all done. So those I'm going to leave as is and paint those up. We've got our radiator mount. I don't know if with that radiator shroud, it fits in beautifully into the front end. So I can super glue that in later. There's no issues with the fit on that. The battery tray is right there. We can do all that later. And I want to make sure that the engine will fit. We can put this in and let it move a little bit, tilt it back while we put it down around the engine, mount it into the chassis, and then push it into place and glue it in. That's my theory, and I can paint this black all by itself off the model. That's why I'm going to do that, so I don't have to cut anything free later. We got our drive shaft all set to go and get painted. We've got our radiator hoses. Those are on their own little tree to get painted. We've got these lovely looking headers, which go together so easily. I'm glad they have these with the large backing on there. They glue together nicely. They should mount up very nicely to the engine. The engine's got large locating tabs on the heads, and those should mate up real well when we drop that into the car. Shouldn't have any problems. Left the valve covers off, left the intake off so I can paint those separately and get those attached to that nice 409 engine. If you wanted to have this as being worked on engine, you could see the rockers and everything. So you could really get in there and detail that and make it look pretty spectacular. We got our starter in there, oil filter, all that stuff is all built into the molds with the lovely headers. We've got our dumps for those headers all set to go. We can get those painted up and attached towards the end. And then we come to the chassis, and that's the end of the glue together build. You can see that rear end goes in very nicely. Even got the link across the back and the link off the top of the differential. Those all fit in well. We've got our suspension. Now, the spindles, I put mine all the way far down with the suspension arms all the way down and those taller springs because, of course, we want this to sit a little nose high. Being a drag car, we want it to sit nose high so that it pushes the weight to the back of the tires. But we've got a nice looking model here. We can detail this. We can paint our tanks. We can gloss up the black for the chassis and the transmission cross members. We can get some silver in here. We can do all kinds of fun stuff with this chassis. We got our steering links and everything on there. And the steering could, I suppose, be posable I glued mine in tight so that it goes nowhere, and then our front wheels will press in when we're all done. Once they have paint on them, they go in nice now. We may have to drill those out with the same size drill bit to clean the paint out of them. You never know, but it's never a big deal. So I'm gonna get this lovely little kit over in the paint, and you can come with me.
Thank you.
time for a closer look-see before I put everything together and it gets a little bit harder to check out. We'll pull the interior out here, and I really like the looks of that. It's a well-molded, definitely those door panels look really sharp. I think it's a very nice-looking interior. I left the rear seat out, figuring if it's a drag racer, they would probably remove that 100 pounds of seat to gain a tenth of a second. I think that's what they said years ago when I was watching the drag races. Every 100 pounds you remove from the vehicle, so if you remove 1,000 pounds, you gain a full second on your quarter time. So that looks really nice. The decals went on easily and laid into their console. We've got it all set up, and like I said, those door panels, super nice looking, and I did it in the red like that. We've got the chassis here. I've got the 409 glued in with the Offenhauser valve covers. Then I just did a little bit of a wash in that Offenhauser so you can see it with the carburation and the high-rise intake. Underneath, we've got the headers. When I get all done, just before I put the decals on, once the body's on, I will attach the outlet pipes to each side, and they will come out. Anyway, kind of maybe get it to hold for a second. There you go. That's what they'll look like when they come out the back. I did dry brush the bottom of the chassis, knowing darn well this wasn't a car that hadn't bounced down the road a couple of times. We got that awesome looking set of slicks on the back and the front wheels. I did not have to drill anything out. They just literally pressed right into place. The steel axle presses into place nicely. Did not have to cut any of that off. And we have a pretty sharp looking gasser chassis. We got the bumper just pressed in. That will be, the grill will be put in permanently when we are all done. Got the hood on with its trim. Got the interior done of the under hood. Got the little ignition box, master cylinder. Got the radiator glued into place and the glass. What I did was I cut the glass. I didn't want the front glass in because then you can't really see inside. So I just cut it off, that big piece of glass that would have been in here. I cut it off and only glued in the back part. Did the trim the way you saw me do it in the video, and we are all set to go. Got the taillights glued in place. They look cool. Got the trim around the back. I've just got to apply the correct decals for the version I built, and when we come back, we'll have the final. Dino Don Nicholson 62 Chevy Bel Air Super Stock 409 Turbo Fire, the name needs to be about 3.5 feet long on the box, is completed. 1/25th scale, very, very easy to assemble. Could easily be a first glue kit if you're just picking up this channel for the first time and thinking of a project. You like 409 cars, you like Bel Airs, you like Dino Don Legends of the Quarter Mile series. This would be an easy one for you. You can build his dragster. You can build some other dragsters with the decals included that we showed in the beginning of the video. And you can build a completely stock 409 62 Bel Air if you wish. Now, when I saw the box art, sometimes I like to just replicate the box art, and that's what I like. It's a very simple yet tough looking design. We got the shiny front wheels, we got the black rears on the big slicks, and they include those nice Goodyears. We got that high stance, we got the pipes coming out from underneath the doors. I just thought it was tough. That nice looking red interior, the molds on the body have been maintained very well. You can easily do all your detailing by hand. You saw how I did the long chrome down the sides to make it a little bit easier on the average builder. We detailed up that interior. The molding of those door panels and the dash are very crisp and very strong, so there's nothing hard to get any paint or detail on. I enjoyed the kit all the way around. That engine is really, really beautiful. Very easy to build on that engine. You have numerous intake options for that engine. You got valve cover options. I use the Offenhauser ones, but you can put the stock ones on there, paint them orange. They've even got decals for those valve covers underneath there if you use the stock ones. The side decals and the trim and the 409 emblems all went on very, very nicely. All the decals, in fact, this decal sheet seemed a step up from previous decal sheets. The decals were glossier. They slid off in one piece. They slid around on the model a little bit easier than normal. So they do seem to be improving, at least as far as these ones went. I used a little bit of decal solvent on the emblem since they are raised, and they laid down in those absolutely beautiful. I just used water for all the side and top decals. They didn't need anything. I did not do any future floor polish over this. The white came out more than glossy enough for a 62 Bel Air that would be used on a drag strip, and the decals would have been laid over that, so I didn't bother doing anything to add any extra shine. That's just how it came right out of the can, and the decals are how they came right off the decal sheet. I thank Round 2 Models for sending this over. I don't know the exact release date. I know it's 2022. Should be within the next 6 to 8 weeks is what it usually happens when I first get one of these samples that comes as the production sample. As you know, I request kits that are exactly what viewers will get when they get theirs. I don't get anything different. That's why I unbox them and show them to you so that you know exactly what you'll be getting. The decal sheets will be the same. The parts will be the same. The box will be the same. It will all be what you see reviewed on the show. As always, when you build your 62 Bel Air, build it your way. If you want to cut those windows like I did so that the driver and passenger side door windows are there and you still get the quarter windows, or if you want to eliminate the entire window on the side, that's up to you. But it can be done easily just by clipping that off like I did. I want you to build your models your way and enjoy them, because that's what a hobby is all about, is you having fun doing things your way. Thanks for watching the workshop. Thanks to Round 2 Models for their continuing support over the years. And we will see all of you at the next review.